He's done a lot of the highest profile cases out there. Not a showman. Does a lot of federal cases as well. And I think this judge has demonstrated that she is not going to be pushed around in the sense that, you know, people always say in high profile cases that defendants get the benefit of the doubt, they're treated easily. It's actually just the opposite, which is in the highest profile cases, the last thing a judge wants is for people to say, you treated him softly.
You're in the tank.
Yeah, you let him off easy. We see it in everything from Lindsay Lohan to this case. Because I think if he hadn't been a high profile person, he would have had a better shot at getting bail at this point.
So what happens next? He's at Rikers Island as we speak.
That's correct. And they're taking great care, meaning Rikers, single cell. Mm-hmm. Anytime he leaves the cell, he has someone accompanying him. So they're not going to let anything happen to him while he's in Rikers Island. And remember, Rikers is generally a place you go in between. It's a place you go pending trial. It's a place. So that's where he is now. Friday is going to be the next hearing, and the focus of the defense is going to be try to get him out on bail. And my sources close to the defense team tell me that they are working on a bail package that they hope will get him released.
What I read is that they're going to argue, perhaps, and whether you can confirm this or not, I don't know, that they may very well be putting together an argument that it was consensual.
Yeah. Well, look, it was going to be one of two things, right? It was either going to be never happened, I wasn't there, I don't know what they're talking about,
right,
or yes, I was there, something happened, and we had some sort of consensual something, whatever that incident was. And it's my sources tell me that it's going to be more likely the latter, which is now that they have DNA evidence, they have physical evidence, I think that the defense is stuck. And they might say we're just telling the truth, but I think their options are limited based on the physical evidence to say that, yes, something happened there, but it wasn't criminal. It wasn't forced. And my understanding is that's what you're going to see as the defense, as this case moves forward. And look, and what's going to happen is what happens in every sexual assault case, which is the defense is going to, as much as possible, put the accuser under the microscope. And the prosecutors are going to do the same to him by looking at every past incident he's been involved in to try to demonstrate that this is a pattern of behavior.
What does it mean in terms of French politics now if he's not going to be the nominee of the Socialist Party?
Well, it means a new departure. It means that all the cards have been reshuffled. I mean, he was the favorite of the public opinion polls. To see the man who was groomed, so to speak, to be the next president of France, handcuffed, unshaved, is a kind of national shock, if not humiliation. Now to say who is going to be the winners, who are going to be the losers from this new political picture is really too early to say, and I would be very prudent. The only thing I would venture is that it can be a plus for the populist of the National Front. They have been anti-elite. Now they can say, we always told you the elite were corrupt, but now they are even depraved. So there is that kind of populist tune that can be played more loudly. For the rest, I think it's much too early to say.
Join us online at charlierose.com.